This is the River Hawk Report for Monday, December 21st, 2009. All quiet on the playing fields, but that doesn't mean that all is quiet at UMass Lowell. In fact, it was not. Saturday was a day of final preparations, and Sunday, the Lowell Holiday Festival 2009 was held at the Campus Recreation Center. Families currently living in shelters in the city invited to the holiday party.
Oh, it's definitely about the spirit of Christmas and trying to giving back to the community. UMass Lowell, you know, giving back to some of the children and the parents in this area that, you know, don't have as much for their kids, for their families this year. So we're trying to do something and give them a day that they can come and, you know, relax, have a good time, be entertained, get a couple presents, do some fun activities with some of the students and some of the volunteers from campus.
That is UMass Lowell Senior Associate Director of Athletics, Joan LaHoulier. She is quick to point out that UMass Lowell, like everybody else, is a resident of this city.
Trying to be a good neighbor to the people in the community, and I think this is one way that we can give back to the people around here that need it right now.
LaHoulier says the idea started with one of the university's assistant track coaches, Barbara Smith.
It all came from Barbara Smith. Our assistant track coach had worked the one in Boston, Christmas in the City. She approached me last spring and said, this is a great event in Boston. I think we could do something like this in Lowell.
Well, I'm also a teacher here in the city of Lowell, and I know that we have many underprivileged children. The joy that I see in the faces of the kids in Boston, I also wanted to bring here to the city of Lowell. Make a little bit of a difference and get our athletes involved with the community that they are living in.
Smith believes there is a lot more to the event than just helping people who may be facing a bit of a struggle. There are lessons as well for the student athletes and students taking part.
Teach them what it is to serve others. There's a lot more that we can do in this community. I think they're good role models for the kids. A lot of these kids come from homes that they could use a good role model, somebody to spend time with them.
And Smith hopes that the event is not just an event, but rather a jumping off point for something more.
I'm hoping that this will grow in other ways of their involvement with the community, maybe in some sort of homework club that they can participate in, or tutoring services, other ways that we can get them involved in the community. And not only just the athletes, but some of just the students here on campus.
UMass Lowell Director of Athletics, Dana Skinner, sees events such as this as a key component in public higher education, along with teaching and research. He says there is service.
And service is a critical component, and you want to make sure everybody that attends a public university gets the concept. And I think this university has always done this well. From all the years in athletics, we ran the National Youth Sports Program, and Student Activities Department here has done an awful lot. So it's kind of part and parcel of the experience at UMass Lowell.
And Skinner says it also helps to knock down walls and bring students together.
Connects our student athletes to the rest of the campus. There are an awful lot of students on this campus that are doing a good many things to help, to lend a helping hand. And sometimes when you're a student athlete, you know, you're an island unto yourself a little bit. Your team is separated from the rest of the campus, and it's events like this that have that can bring the entire campus community together, and that's good for the students. They need to be exposed to other students.
Skinner also says the event, the holiday party on a college campus, can also get young people thinking about their future and thinking about college.
The sooner they get college placed on their personal agendas, the better chance we think they'll have of actually attaining that.
The weekend snowstorm did cut into attendance, but it did not reduce the good times enjoyed by those who took part in either the preparations or attended the event. And that's the River Hawk Report for Monday, December 21st, 2009.